Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. First of all, a very happy new year to all of you. Today, I am going to show you how to install Java. So to install Java, first you need to go to your favorite browser and just type JDK download. And here, you need to click on this Java downloads. So this link I am going to put right in our description. And here you need to just simply scroll down and here you need to switch over to Windows. So we are installing it for Windows, so I'm going to switch to Windows tab and I'm going to click on this link. So that is x64 MSI installer, and you can see that our Java 21 is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel it. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that we already have Java 21 downloaded over here. So just simply double click on the installer. So this is our Java installation wizard. You need to just simply click on next. So this is where our Java is going to be installed. So if you want to change your destination, you can just simply click on this button and you can change that. I don't want to change anything. I want to keep this default, so I'll simply cancel this. I'll keep this default and click on next. And it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and you can see our installation has rightly begun. And our installation is successfully completed. So you can see the message, Java TMAC development kit version 21.0.1 for 64-bit is successfully installed. So once our Java get installed, you can just simply close this. You can minimize this directory as well. So now that you know that our Java is installed, it's time to set our environment variable. So for that, you need to go to the search and just simply type over here environ. When you type that, you'll be seeing this edit the system environment variables. So just simply open that and you will get this window, system properties window. So here you need to click on environment variables and you will get this environment variables window. So here you need to, under system variables, you need to click on this path and you need to click on edit. So sometimes this edit button might not be there, so you can just simply select the path. You can just simply double click, so that will also open the same edit environment variable window. So here you need to add a new entry over here. So what entry you need to do is you need to again go to your C drive and go to program files, then Java folder, then JDK21, then bin folder, and you need to copy this path. Okay, so just simply right click and copy the path. Now you can minimize this, and here you need to just simply click on new, then right click and paste that path over here. So Java, so C program files Java JDK21/bin path is what we need to paste it over here. You can now just simply click on OK. So now that our path is tightly set, it's time to set our Java home. So for that, you need to just simply click on new, and here you need to just simply type Java underscore home. Alright, and a variable value you need to just again right click and paste. But this time remember to delete this bin folder. We don't need this bin folder anymore. Alright, so we need till JDK21. That's all. And then just simply click on OK. And then again OK. And then again OK. So now if you again go to your search icon and just simply type CMD and just simply open our command prompt. Here, if you just simply type Java space dash dash version and just simply hit enter, you can see that our latest version of Java JDK version 21.0.1 is rightly installed on our system. Alright, so if you see this similar type of message, then all you know that your Java is successfully installed on your system. If you see some message like JDK is not recognized as an internal or an external command, then or Java is not recognized, so then all that basically mean is you have made some mistake in middle. Okay, so best thing is you follow the video all over again, or else you can always put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Alright, so now that your Java is installed, it's time to write one short program, Hello World program. So I'm going to create a new folder and I'm going to name this folder as Java, and I'm going to go inside that folder. Next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new text document, and here I'm going to give the file name as Hello World, and here if you see that this file is getting saved as a text document, right? So we need to change it to .java. So go to file and here you need to check this enable file name extension. So file name extension, you need to just simply check that, enable it. So once you enable that, you can see that .txt is showing over here, right? So you need to rename this and you need to change this .txt with .java and simply click on outside and yes. So now you can see that our file type is changed with .java, right? So it is a Java file type. So let's open the file with a notepad. So now just I'm going to write a simple program. So class Hello World, then I'm going to give parentheses and I'm going to write public static void main string args. So don't worry, this code I am going to provide you right in our description, so you can also copy it and paste it on your code. And here I am going to just simply do system.out.println. Hello world. So this string will be capital S, as string is class in Java. So you can see that here hello H is capital because hello world is a class. So all the class initial we always start with capital. All right, so now go to file and save this. Go back to your folder, just simply type cmd over here and hit enter to open the command prompt right at this location. And now you need to just simply type Java C. This C basically means compilation. Then your file name, which is HelloWorld.java. So HelloWorld.java. Hit enter. You can see that our file got compiled successfully. So it has generated dot class file. So now to run this dot class file, you need to just simply type Java. Then the class name, which is HelloWorld. So HelloWorld. And hit enter, and you can see the output hello world is rightly shown in our console. So in this way you can easily install latest version of Java on a Windows 10 operating system. So that's basically all about this video. Please do like, share and subscribe, that will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.